that's pretty much it.
Where did he go then?
Nobody knows. It's a story the old one back home told me.
You sure got a lot to tell.
Yeah, well.
Look at that place.
Ah, Parwood Village.
What happened there? Looks pretty dead.
Indeed. Let me tell you a story. This place has a story that's been told through many generations now. Listen carefully.
A long time ago, when the sorcerers and the Burning Legion ruled our world, there was an Archmage of Dalaran who studied something that could be revolutionary. He had discovered other creatures from another dimension, but was afraid of his own findings. He believed that if somebody was to open a portal and let them into our world, the consequences would be grave. He realized that others may try to take advantage of his great power at some point to fight the Scourge and the Burning Legion. So he wrote a book about his investigations. The purpose of the book was to give people a better understanding of what they committed themselves to.
The land of Azeroth is host to no end of wonders. Flora, fauna, cultures, and magic all teem across its surface. Indeed, the curious will find limitless variety on this world. One merely has to look. But if one looks deeply enough, then windows to entire new worlds are found, and each world is home to its own wonders, just as each world is home to its own horrors. It is my hope that no Dalaran wizard seeks out the Worgen, even if done in light conscience. For no pact may be struck, no secrets may be learned, no good can come from these beasts. They are best left to their world, for if found in ours and not destroyed, our peril will be dire.
Time came when Dalaran was eventually attacked by the Scourge, and many of the great wizards perished.
However, there was one wizard who managed to escape it all. Archmage Aragal. He fled to Shadowfang Keep and Silverpine to survive the horrors of battle, to bide some time, and to find a way to combat the Scourge.
Baron Silverlane and his servants gave Aragal a warm welcome, and he continued with his studies within the high walls of Shadowfang. Aragal was one of the Archmages who was interested in Ur's research. After the attack on Dalaran, they were left weak in number, and Aragal wanted to improve the forces against the Scourge.
At the same time, in the land of Kalimdor, the demons from the Burning Legion ravaged the place under the command of Manaroth. The sentinel Valende Starsong was given the task to clear out the demons in Fellwood. Valende prayed to Ilun for assistance, and was heard. She was given the Scythe of Ilun, which could summon and control the Worgen. She used the Worgen to defeat and clear out the demons in Fellwood, but at some point they didn't listen to her anymore. To investigate further, she gathered as many packs as she could find, and ordered them to remain at the shrine of Melthandris. Then she traveled to the libraries in Darnassus, but without luck. She had heard of the Dalaran Archmage Aragao and booked passage from Ratchet to Booty Bay. After the Sentinel came to the Forest of Duskwood, nobody heard anything from her again. Milleria Frostshadow has taken over her job in the woods, clearing out the demons and believing that one day Valende will return back home. After a while, Aragao lost control over them as well. They did not only attack the Scourge, but the wizards themselves. The Worgen went on a rampage and attacked the former Lord of Shadowfang Keep, Baron Silverloon, and the rest of his servants. A depressed and lonely Aragao decided to adopt the Worgen as his own, and so they became his family. He also lay a curse upon the nearby village of Pyrewood. At day, the villagers were in their normal form, but during the night, you could hear them through the forest. Aragao now lives alone in the fortress with his Worgen, and the current location of the scythe is unknown.
That's a pretty neat story. One of my favorites. We should probably be getting back home now. It's getting dark.
What was that?